Very warm good morning to all my students and most welcome to all the students of Standard 7. Children, you must keep your notebook with you so that whatever the PPT I am showing you, you have to note down. And you enjoy the class regularly and as you are sitting in the class. There will be no any confusion regarding your subject. And I am Seema Rai as your science teacher, and you will study just now of your textbooks lesson number 2. That lesson is what nutrition in living organisms, animals and man. You see how the mode of nutrition in animals, this picture is showing to you as you studied in previous classes, that is the food chain. This is showing food chain. So you can see here how the sun's energy is absorbed by the plants and then energy transferred to the herbivores, carnivores, omnivores. In this way, you see these. The mode of nutrition in different animals are different. Suppose take the example of carnivores. They depend for food on what? That herbivores, and their teeth structure, their mouth structure, that must be different. So related to this chapter, these are the contents. You see properly and you note down. That is, first is introduction, mode of intake of food, food habits of animals, nutrition in humans, and absorption of digested food in a small intestine, nutrition in grass eating animals, and nutrition in amoeba. These are the contents. Then one by one we will discuss. First is in the introduction. Your chapter name is nutrition. So children, you must know what is the meaning of nutrition. You see that it is the process of providing and obtaining the food necessary for health and growth. So nutrition is very, very important for our health. If we are taking the nutrients and that keep us healthy. So we should know that in all type of animals, what type of the mode of nutrition that is takes place. You see here, that is the main steps of the animal nutrition. First is food requirement and food habit. What type of food is required for the special organism, and mode of intake of food. How the food is taken by the organism. Suppose we are taking our food by mouth. Next is utilization of in the body. How this food, if we will take the food, how it is utilized. Now see a small ideas about the heterotrophs. It is written here, the animals are heterotrophs in which they depend on food on others and eat complex food material and break down into the simpler forms. It means heterotrophs depends for food on others. We are also the heterotrophs because only the autotrophs are the plants that are green plants which can prepare their food. You studied in the previous classes, that is by the process of photosynthesis. Here second is written, complex food like carbohydrates, proteins, fats, and the food are broken down into the simpler form. I have written here that what is the meaning of the complex food. You see that carbohydrate, and I have given the example for one, that is simplest form of the carbohydrate is glucose. As you know that you are taking the food, that is rice, chapatis, that are every day. So these are what? Carbohydrates, but in the simplest form, that is breakdown into the glucose. Like that also proteins, the simplest form of proteins is what? That is amino acid. You also studied about this. Next you have to see here the mode of, second is your mode of intake of food. It is different in different organisms. You have been given, that is several pictures here, and it is explained here that what? First picture is what? The bird. First picture is what? Hummingbird. This picture is of hummingbird, and it has the long tubular beak and how it is ready to suck the nectar of the flower. So intake of food is what? Long beak. Like that, second picture is of what? That is snake, and a snake has a big jaws. So larger than their head, it can swallow the prey. So it is showing also the intake of food is different. Next, third picture is of cow. Cow has also the incisor and flat molar teeth. Cow is depending for food on what? Plants, and that is grasses mostly. So their sharp teeth is helping in crushing, cutting and chewing the with the help of molar teeth. And fourth picture, that is of sparrow. Very common bird surrounding us, you all have seen I think. And this sparrow has what you are watching, very small beak. This beak is used by sparrow to pick up the seeds and the worms. So it is clear to all of you. So children, you can draw the picture, because these are very common, and at a glance if you are watching, you can draw it. Next, your topic is food habits of animals. Food habits, according to the food habits, also the animals are classified into what? Herbivores, carnivores and omnivores. And all pictures are given here. You see that first picture is of deer that eat plants material only. Surrounding you also there is goat, cow, buffaloes, rabbit. These are also herbivores because they are depending for food on plants. Second is what? Carnivores. Carnivores eat flesh of other animals. You see, these are carnivores. You know that tiger, cheetah, these are the names that are carnivores. Omnivores, very common example, that is crow, showing to you. This is omnivores because eat flesh of animals and the plant material. So very, very clear to all of you, and you note down and you can draw any picture according to you. Next is that in this book also, in very short, it is given the discussion about heterotrophic nutrition. But you already studied in lesson 1. What is here? Organisms depend for food on others, that are heterotrophic nutrition. So these are categorized in 3 types. First is what? Your saprotrophic nutrition. And in the saprotrophic, what is written? Organism depends for food on dead and decaying plants and animal matter. And very, very common example is fungi and bacteria. You know what is fungi? So fungi is what? That is non-green plant. And very common example it is given to you, that is mushroom. Children, you have to note down something that I am saying that is very, very important. And non-green plant, that is mushroom, but this is edible fungi, but harmful fungi is also, just like bread mold. So this mushroom is the rich source of the protein, and you eat also this mushroom during winter, it is very easily available. Second is bacteria. Children, you should know the common name bacteria, everyone knows. This bacteria is harmful for us also and useful for us. So bacteria is, in one line, can you say what is bacteria? Children, in one line you note down, bacteria is a plant, always remember. And most common bacteria, as you know every day at your home, that is curd. Curd is made by lactobacillus bacteria. So this is the example. And bacteria is also helping. Several types of bacteria are known and helping in decomposing the plants and animals after death. Next you see, that is parasitic nutrition. What are parasites, children? The mode of nutrition in parasite is what? That is, depends for food on other living organism. So here it is given the example of the animals. What is the picture? It is given the picture of leech, and second is tapeworm. Leech, where it is surviving? That is mostly present in the pond. And if it sticks to the body of animal or human being, that sucks the blood. So it is a parasite. Like tapeworm also, see the picture. And these all come under the parasite. So mode of nutrition is known as parasitic nutrition. Third is your holozoic nutrition. That is very, very important, children. Organisms take their food in solid or liquid state. Example is written, amoeba and man. It is given to you the picture of amoeba and the man. Why it is the smallest organism that are unicellular? Amoeba is unicellular animal. So we can't see it with naked eyes, because unicellular animal is only seen with the help of microscope. And what is another example is of man. Man is what? Multicellular. So these two, we take our food in the solid form, as you are eating the chapatis, rice, that are what? In the solid form. And it is digesting in our body. Like that amoeba also. Amoeba is a water animal. So if the food comes near the amoeba, their body parts, that is, arise the false feet. And you will study about that, or I think you studied that pseudopodia. That is showing the outgrowth. It is given in your this picture. And this amoeba is also engulfing the food particles, and digestion takes place in the body. So the smallest organism, that is amoeba, unicellular, and the multicellular animal, that is man, is given you the examples. Children, you studied very well, I think. And any confusion regarding this, you can ask to me any question. And in last, I am giving you suggestion that whatever I have shown you, the pictures that are very, very clear, start from the beginning and you can draw at your home in your special homework notebook. Here is some worksheet is given to you. You have to answer these questions. First is what? Give reason cow is a heterotrophs. Meaning why cow is heterotroph, you have to note down. And I think easily you can write it. Second is differentiate between saprotroph and parasite. This is also very easy. Give reason crow is omnivores. Why crow is kept under the omnivores, you have to write. Write two examples of herbivores and carnivores. This is also very simple. And next is draw the picture of hummingbird and a sparrow. You have to show here their beaks. Clear to all of you? And just thank you to all of you.